The tropical rainforest of Malaysia is estimated to be more than 130 million years old. These rainforests date back to a time when dinosaurs still roamed the earth. These forests are older than their counterparts in the Amazon or the Congo. Our forest is home to our rich biodiversity and a source of ecosystem services which we depend for our survival, such as food, medicines, clean water, and clean air. Three ASEAN countries, Indonesia, Malaysia, and the Philippines, are among 17 megadiverse countries of the world. Megadiverse countries are those that harbor most of the biodiversity on Earth. But the rainforest is being threatened by deforestation to make room for logging, road development, and major dams. For example, in 2020, Malaysia lost 2.7 million hectares of humid primary forest. Countries need to act. At the Earth Summit in 1992, UN member states agreed to halt biodiversity loss by signing the UN Biodiversity Treaty. Negotiations of the treaty took 2 years to complete, 1990 to 1992. This is the essence of science diplomacy, whereby political leaders, policymakers, diplomats, and legal experts listen to the advice of the scientists and develop agreements or treaties to have a better world. Diplomacy is the act of building good relations between two bilateral or more than two multilateral countries. Diplomacy is quite an ancient practice. For example, Admiral Zheng He's journeys to Malacca during the 1400s and making alliances with the Sultan. Diplomacy could sometimes get quite ugly. Science diplomacy is the conduct of international relations using science as the medium of exchange to tackle national and global challenges such as global pandemics, climate change, biodiversity loss, and plastic pollution. Science diplomacy can be applied in three dimensions of policy: informing foreign policy objectives with scientific advice, facilitating international science cooperation, using science cooperation to improve international relations between countries. The IISDS at UCSI University is the first center of excellence in the ASEAN region. We intend to train budding young diplomats from Malaysia and the rest of the ASEAN region in the theory and practice of science diplomacy. Eventually, we would like to see it as a source of reference for nationals from the developing countries. Welcome to the launch of IISDS at UCSI University.